Emotions are universal, universal values. And in my approach to comparative literature, it is not so much important. It is not so important to see whether an author has been inspired by another one, and maybe if in his writing there are words, phrases, and other structural aspects that derive from another author. It is more the emotional purport that interests me, because ultimately what catches our heart and makes us feel involved in this subcreative experience is what touches our emotional sphere. So Tolkien, in my personal approach, is a great innovator in the sense that, as it has been said by Italian critics, he recreates, he reproposes the classical myths in the modern world. In this precise sense, that he catches the true meaning of the world myth, that is, tale, story, and which implies a series of sequence of symbolic meanings, and reproposes them in a world that is ours and isn't ours at the same time. We don't live in Middle-earth, but we can find the emotions and the perceptions that Middle-earth gives us in the world we live in. It's a sort of intimate dialogue between our dimension and this emotional sphere that is inside each of us.